Hello, I'm Brother Jim Simon, Director of Development here at Dominican Academy, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to our auction and benefit this evening. I'd like to give a special thanks to the many people who made this auction possible. To DA's Alumni Association, particularly Nicole DeFilippi and Katie Hennessy, to DAPA, our Parents Association, especially Celeste Segura and Joan Malico, to thank also Dorothy Filaramo, Melissa Wheeler, and our auction sponsors, who are all listed on our website. We congratulate our honorees this evening, Kristen Shea from the class of 82, and she's also a parent from the class of 2019, and the Dovich family, and they'll be with us later in the program. Also, we welcome alumni and friends from around the world who are joining us this evening through the benefit of this auction being virtual. We have alumni joining us tonight from the across the USA, from Canada, Australia, Italy, France, and Ireland. And we're so happy you could join us. To participate in DA's auction this evening, we ask you to register by going to the website, www.bidpal.net/Dominican Academy, and then go to the top right corner to register. In the past 7 months, the world has come to a screeching halt, but the education at DA has not. Albeit virtually, our girls continue to learn, grow, and be challenged. Your contributions to the auction tonight will help enable DA to stay strong in spite of this pandemic. It will also help each and every girl at DA by keeping tuition low. On behalf of all of us, thank you to the parents, alumni, and friends for your support that allows DA and our students to thrive. We also want to thank Sister Pat Tuhill, the prioress, and her congregation of Dominican Sisters of Peace for their loyal care and support of DA for 123 years. It's my honor now to introduce you to our president, Sister Margaret Ormond.
Good evening, and welcome to Dominican Academy's first ever virtual auction and benefit. As with all things, I'd like to begin tonight with a prayer. And I use the prayer that we've created for the sending of our seniors off. And now we're using it for the sending of all of you off to the auction. And it goes like this. God of all journeys, provider for all our needs, we come to you as a pilgrim people. Inspired by St. Catherine and Dominic, we walk towards a future we cannot see clearly, and which we enter as deep mystery. We pray for the guidance of the Spirit, for the grace that opens us to the truth and the challenges that await us. With faith in your word and hope in your promises, may we dwell in gratitude for all that has been and all yet to come. Impelled by love, we give ourselves to the journey. Impelled by love, we give ourselves to this evening's activity. This past year has been particularly challenging for all of us at Dominican Academy and for the entire world, wouldn't you say? However, regardless of the obstacles placed before us, we have maintained a focus on our mission to challenge and empower the intelligent young women who come through our doors to become spiritual, intellectual, moral, and socially responsible leaders in our global society. And our strong DA community has persevered. In May, 64 seniors graduated and were accepted in the best Catholic colleges, 6 of the 8 Ivy League schools, and an impressive list of other colleges and universities. And they were awarded over $25 million in college merit scholarships and grants. As we move forward into this new school year, albeit still uncertain, we continue to reinforce in our students the pillars of our Dominican Academy pledge, to search for truth in all its dimension, to work to create a caring community, and to reach out to others through preaching and just actions, and to unfold our lives in prayer. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts for your support and for joining us tonight. We welcome our alumni, current families, and friends from here, near and far. We are truly grateful for you. Your participation in the auction tonight will help us to continue to offer high-quality education to the wonderful students here at Dominican Academy. Thank you, and may God reward you for your generosity.
Well, thank you so much, Sister Margaret. Brother Jim as well. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jim Miller, and I will be your host this evening. I would normally be in the position of being your auctioneer, and I would want nothing more than to right now be standing on the stage at the Metropolitan Club and to meet and greet each of you for my first time here with DA. But we'll do this virtually, and I look forward to seeing y'all next year. So we thank you so much. I echo everything that Sister Margaret and Brother Jim have said. We could not do this without you. We thank you for being here. Everything that you do tonight is going to help these amazing young women. You're going to hear from a wide variety of the DA community, from students and alumna to honored guests and representatives of the Board of Trustees. Our goal tonight, during these unprecedented times, is to virtually provide you with an informative and entertaining evening while supporting the continued growth at DA. Now, most of you have already gotten the text message so that you're registered and you're able to bid. Hopefully you've looked around on the page and maybe found a few things that you'd like to bid on, and we'll cover some of those and highlight a few items. If you haven't, you've got two options. The easy one, if you're on your phone, you can text Dominican Academy, no spaces, to 243-725. And then it kind of takes over from there. You'll get a text message back, you fill out your information, and it'll take you about 3 minutes. If you're working on a computer, as said earlier by Brother James, you can go to bidpal.net/Dominican Academy, and you can log in there and sign up. But most of you have already registered, so you've gotten the emails and you're already in on this. So hopefully you're finding things that you want to bid on. If there's not something you want to bid on, certainly know that your contributions are greatly appreciated throughout the evening. The auction will continue beyond our program tonight. It will close on this Tuesday, September 29th at 9 o'clock. And you will again get plenty of reminders if you're bidding on things, so it won't sneak up on you, but we didn't want you to think that you had to get it all done here in the next 45 minutes. So we appreciate that. Did you get the email for our official cocktail/mocktail for tonight? I hope you did. It's the Veritas Sour. And if that is your thing, we would encourage you to get that going. Maybe get the drink before you start the actual bidding. It's been known to help as you're going through the process. If you haven't gotten that, then we're just so happy that you're even here. I mentioned a couple of items we wanted to highlight in the auction tonight, and there are many more than this, but of special note, how about Cocktails and a Conversation for Four with Sister Margaret over at Isle of Capri, a DA alum-owned authentic Italian eatery in New York City. That is up available for bid. I think I saw the bidding around $650, which seems awfully low. Let's see if we can get that up considerably more before the end of tonight. You can hang out with Dr. Leslie Petit, dinner for six, and in addition to it being dinner, there's actually a pasta making component to it. Our beloved DA chef, Miss Maria Bruno, is going to show you how to make the actual dinner, and then you get to sit down and enjoy it with five of your friends and Dr. Petit. A little vacation trip. You might think during the pandemic, and rightfully so, that a lot of vacation opportunities are a little tough to get to right now. We have been very fortunate. You're gonna see a wide variety. We've got a great Antigua trip and other Caribbean getaways and some a little closer to home. And with very few exceptions, all of them have extended the expiration date. So it's not like normally you might get a year to use this. Some of these going well into 2022. So please take a look at those items and bid thoroughly. You've got until Tuesday, but we want to see a lot of action tonight, and we look forward to you doing your part. So whether you buy something in the auction or you donate directly, you are supporting DA's ability to provide crucial scholarships and to help you ensure DA can keep tuition, as Sister Margaret said, at a reasonable rate, so all these amazing girls can benefit from a Dominican education. As mentioned, 34% of students at DA receive partial scholarships, and the end result, we talk so much in education about it being an investment. the fruits of your donations are so evident. Over $25 million in college merit scholarships just last year. So this year in particular, we've also added in there an emphasis on providing the additional tech resources so that these young women can do their remote learning experience. Maybe they need a laptop or they need a little bit of help with Wi-Fi routers. A lot of the money that we're raising here tonight, and not a lot of it, but a portion of it, will go towards making sure we can maintain that. Our goal tonight for each of you is 100% participation. We have no expectation that each of you will want to spend $5,000 on vacations tonight. It's just not practical. But we want you to understand that if that's what you want, then great. But also, your contributions of $10, of $50, of $100 are exceptional. And if somebody you know is not tuned in tonight, then you can get them on there. Think of maybe another alumna that isn't on board tonight. Maybe they've got something else going on. They're fortunate enough to be working. Send them a text message and send them that information, and then they can get in there. Maybe they just throw $20 or $50. If you sent that text message out to 10 of your friends and each of them gave $20, that's a pretty good return on about a minute and a half of your time tonight. So we would love to see that continue to grow tonight. You can see already, thanks to Angela for making her contribution, we're over just under $25,000. We're about halfway there. So whatever it is you can contribute, we are so grateful that you can be here tonight. I'm terribly excited to be part of this tonight, and I thank you for the opportunity. We've got a lot ahead. Let's get things going. First up, it is Dominican Academy Principal, Dr. Leslie Petty.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Leslie Poole Petit, Principal of Dominican Academy and proud parent of two DA alumnae, Sally and Natalie. As you heard from Sister Margaret, even though this year looks quite different from school years in the past, we continue to provide students an all honors education in the tradition of St. Dominic. We are also committed more than ever to the safety and well-being of each member of our community. Our faculty and staff work tirelessly to engage DA students, whether in the traditional or virtual classroom. Tonight, you will hear from many alumnae from across the years. To kick that off, it is my pleasure to present Catherine DiMatteo, a DA Board of Trustees scholar from the class of 2018. At DA, Catherine was extremely involved in many organizations, including organizing DA's first ever homeless outreach program, which is still one of DA's most popular service projects. She was co-editor of Student Prints and a member of Regis Repertory. In college, Catherine wanted to continue her service and many interests and ultimately chose Georgetown. Currently, she's living at home with her family in Manhattan, studying at Georgetown remotely, but we have our fingers crossed that she can return to Georgetown next semester. It is my privilege and honor to introduce Catherine DiMatteo.
My name is Catherine DiMatteo, and I am a junior at Georgetown University. I was the Board of Trustees scholar in DA's class of 2018. To say that DA made me into an intelligent woman wouldn't do justice to the transformation I experienced during my 4 years on 68th Street. Undoubtedly, my teachers and my peers challenged me to work harder, to think critically, and to communicate with clarity and purpose. DA is the reason I can formulate a thesis, write a lab report, and participate thoughtfully in class discussions. What the word intelligent hides, though, is that DA shaped my character as much as it did my intellect. My service experiences and social justice classes instilled in me a lifelong commitment to equity and helping others. I see a direct connection between my time at DA and my choice to pursue Georgetown's interdisciplinary program in education, inquiry, and justice. DA also provided me the skills and space to flourish as a servant leader, an opportunity I credit with paving the way for my leadership roles in college. The faculty at DA were always willing to lend their time and guidance, even after school and on weekends, to help me see my dreams to fruition, and I can't imagine who I'd be today without their unwavering support. Most importantly, DA never let me forget that reaching out to others first and foremost requires caring for those closest to you, for your sisters. I loved every moment at DA, and I am so grateful to have attended a school that gave me the skills and values to lead a successful, fulfilling, caring life.
Congratulations, and thank you again, Dr. Petit. It's going to be an amazing evening. You're going to hear from wonderful students and alumni tonight, and we just, again, couldn't be happier to have you here. Many of you are supporters financially in advance of the event. All of them are listed on the website, and you should have ample opportunity to look through them. In particular, though, we want to thank Sister Margaret Ormond, also the Dominican Academy Parents Association, Charlene Coleman Harris, Edward Pinter, and Kristen G. Shea, Marion J. Sullivan, the Atlanta Consulting Group and Ed Mickelson, Virginia Connor, Kelly Curry, and Tara Scher, as well as the Dovich family for making this all happen tonight. Dovich, I apologize. We just couldn't do this without you, and many, many more, again, listed on the website. Again, a reminder, get in if you're bidding on anything. It continues through Tuesday, but we want to see a big bump today. We're halfway to our goal already. Text Dominican Academy to 243-725. Here we have our first amazing honoree tonight. We want to introduce the chair of the Board of Trustees. I leave you in the capable hands of Mary Sullivan.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mary Sullivan, and I am the chair of the Board of Trustees here at Dominican Academy. And I am also a parent of an alumna. My daughter, Teresa, graduated in 2013. And on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I would like to welcome everyone to tonight's event. It is my pleasure to introduce the honorees for the program. Our first honoree, Kristen Shea. Kristen is an alumna from 1982. She is also a parent of alumna. Her daughter, Sophia, graduated in 2019. Kristen is well known in the DA community as she has given her time and talent over the last 20 years in many capacities. She currently serves on the Board of Trustees. She sits on the Strategic Planning Committee. She has served on the President's Search Committee, and she now sits on the newly formed DEI Committee. She also served as the President of the Parents Association during her daughter's time here at DA. And just this June, she was voted in as the Vice Chair for the Board of Trustees for the upcoming school year. Alumni like Kristen, who continue to give back and stay connected to DA, allow us to continue the DA tradition of empowering and educating the young women of today, a tradition that goes back to 1897. And so tonight, Kristen, we thank you for your dedicated service and for the time, talent, and treasure that you have given to DA over these last two decades. Our second honoree is the Dovich family in memory of their mother, Mary Elizabeth. Mary Elizabeth was a devout Catholic and enrolled all eight of her children into parochial schools. Her daughter, Karen Haas, attended Dominican Academy on a four-year scholarship and graduated in 1979. Karen, her brother Stephen, and their siblings have set up a family scholarship in memory of their mother, so that other students may have the opportunity for a Dominican education. By paying forward this gift of education, they are honoring both the experience Karen received here at DA and their mother's devotion to faith. Families, such as the Dovich family, play a major role in allowing us to build our scholarship fund to support those girls who would not normally have the opportunity to attend our beloved school. So tonight, to all the Dovich family, we are proud to honor you for your continued support. In a few minutes, you will hear from both of our honorees, but before we get to them, we would like to share a video from our grateful students. Thank you very much.
Our story. It begins here in our shared home, Dominican Academy.
Our story is about a place we call home.
And the people, some very special people we honor tonight.
These people helped make DA a better place.
A better place for us.
For us! For all of us!
This story about giving.
About giving back.
And all that giving can do.
All that giving can mean for students like me.
Like me.
Like us!
DA is a better place because of tonight's honorees. We recognize Kristen Shea, Mary Elizabeth Dovich, and the Dovich family. We celebrate their extraordinary contributions to the DA community.
To our community.
Thank you, Kristen Shea, proud member of DA's class of 82. Kristen's selflessness, boundless energy and enthusiasm, and her heartfelt dedication to Dominican Academy makes her instrumental to our success. By giving of herself,
her time,
her efforts,
her energies,
she has drawn us together as a community devoted to the pillars of Dominican education. Her faithful dedication to DA has made it possible for us to flourish here. Kristen was instrumental in improving our day-to-day experience here. Like our new emphasis on athletics, and improved technology throughout the building. Even the selection of Sister Margaret as DA's first president, who adds so much to our daily experience as DA girls. We also recognize the ongoing support of the Dovich family. Tonight, in a special way, we recognize and honor the memory of Mrs. Mary Elizabeth Dovich, whose daughter Karen is a valued member of DA's class of 79. Mary Elizabeth, the proud mother of 8, was a devout Catholic who was born, raised, and educated in New York City. DA awarded a full 4-year scholarship to Karen, enabling the other Dovich children to remain in Catholic schools. Mary never forgot the generosity of the Dominican Academy sisters, and it was her wish to pay it forward. To give back, Karen and her siblings continue this legacy through their love and support of DA.
By paying it forward.
By providing the Dovich Family Scholarship Fund so that other deserving students could receive the same opportunity afforded to Mary's children.
We thank you.
Thank you. Because DA is a better place since you came along.
A better place because of you.
Please know that your gift will continue to grow.
Through me.
Through me.
Through me.
Through us!
On behalf of us, of all of us, we thank you. With your love and support,
together,
we are
DA.
It's a better place since you came along. It's a better place since you came along.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us tonight in support of Dominican Academy. I am so incredibly grateful for this kind and humbling honor, and I am thrilled to be sharing it with the Dovich family this evening. I would like to congratulate them and thank them for their generosity over the years, particularly in the form of scholarships, which have been so helpful for our girls. As for me, I really do not deserve any credit other than having said yes to joining a committee over 20 years ago. One thing led to the other, and here I am tonight. While this is a bit embarrassing and it feels undeserved, it really does mean so much to me because it comes from a community of people whom I adore and respect and who have taught me so much. These exceptional people, both present and past, have my heartfelt gratitude for all that they have done for DA and all that they have done for me. In the various positions that I have held over the years, I have seen firsthand, from the administration to the faculty and staff to alumni, parents and trustees, the unwavering commitment of these individuals who have worked so tirelessly to ensure that DA's tradition of excellence continues unabated. Now, I would love to be able to thank each and every one of them tonight by name, but in the interest of time, I will save that for a later date offline. But I absolutely must thank all of the people who worked so hard to make this night's event possible, starting with our president, Sister Margaret Ormond, our principal, Dr. Leslie Petit, the head of the advancement office, Brother Jim Simon, his assistant, Melissa Weiler, board chair, Mary Sullivan, our tech guru, Bao Chen, the event committee, all of the people who donated items for the auction, and each and every one of you who are tuning in tonight with us. I would also like to send a very special thank you to Sister Pat Tuhill and her leadership team from the Dominican Sisters of Peace. And while I am doling out thank yous, I would be woefully remiss if I did not include in my gratitude list my husband, Ed, my son, Lucas, my daughter, Sophia, class of 2019, my DA friends, my friends outside of DA, and especially my Italian grandmother, Ines Finoli, who back in 1952 had the foresight to send my mother to DA and begin our family legacy. Now, before I go, I must also encourage you all to become more involved with DA as a volunteer. There are many rewarding opportunities available, including work on Board of Trustee committees, with the Parents Association, if you're a parent, with the Alumni Association, just to name a few. Now, not only will you be doing good deeds for Dominican Academy, but studies show that volunteer work lowers the rates of heart disease and depression. So what more do you need to know? It's good for you. So in closing, as one of our loved Dominican saints, St. Catherine of Siena, once said, nothing great is ever achieved without much enduring. Well, we all have certainly endured some incredibly trying times over the past 6 months, but I truly believe that we will come out of it better and stronger. And with your help, so will DA. That's why we are all here tonight, after all, to ensure the DA continues stronger and better than ever. At the end of the day, we do everything that we do for our girls. So thank you again so very much. Please allow me to dedicate this honor in the memory of my parents, Tom and Vilma Shea, who sent me to DA, thus continuing the legacy. And I'd also like to dedicate it to the wonderful young women of Dominican Academy. Their exuberance, intellect, empathy, passion, and joy inspire me and make me very proud. Enjoy the rest of the evening, and I hope to see you all soon in person. Be well, be safe, and love to all my family and friends that are tuning in tonight. Peace.
Wow. Thank you to the DA girls in that video, that moving video I just watched. And thank you to Brother Jim Simon and all the staff who've worked doubly hard to make this fundraiser a reality. And seriously, it was doubly hard because they had to work last spring and then again for tonight's online version because of the pandemic. So I'm here tonight because my mother, Mary Elizabeth Dovich, loved this school, Dominican Academy. Mom's youngest sister, Therese Monahan of the Order of Preachers, lives out at the Queen of the Rosary Mother House in Amityville, Long Island. And she was the first person in our family to get a doctorate, and we're all very proud of her. And I know it's a different branch of the order, but to my mother, it was close enough. Once she heard the word Dominican, she knew this was the place for me, and she insisted I go to take that scholarship test, even though with seven other children besides me, she couldn't find the time to take me there herself. So I ended up tagging along with Maria Chagoyan and Kathy Arcabasio, and lucky me, our trio became my carpool for the next few years because I won a full four-year scholarship. And that was really a gift for my entire family. It meant one less child they had to worry about, really. And to celebrate, my mother bought me a new coat to wear on this commute, one that she thought was worthy of the school. And it was stunning. It had a rabbit fur collar. And it was something that my mother, who was an off-Broadway actress, really would have loved to have had for herself. But she bought it for me. And she was quite annoyed when I ended up taking off the collar because I thought it was way too fancy. And I felt like an imposter in it. And I have to admit, I feel a little bit like that now too, because I'm very humbled to be here. And I'm just happy that I'm able to give back a small fraction of what I feel I owe the school. like the relationship we all have with our mothers, we can never fully repay what's been given to us, but I'm delighted that my big, wonderful family has decided to also help with this fundraiser. And thank you to all of them for being here tonight. From this gem of a school, I learned how to be an adult. I learned how to reason and form my own opinions. And because of that, I can feel comfortable and confident in most situations, especially the ones where I don't have to wear rabbit fur. So thank you again, Brother Jim, and all of you who've worked so hard to make tonight's fundraiser a reality. Well done. May DA, like all of our mothers, live in our hearts forever.
A couple of amazing families, the Shays and the Doviches. So many more too tonight. We want you to hear from them as well. A reminder, I'm just reminding you because I can't sell you any more tickets. We had a big grand raffle and we had 200 tickets and we sold out. So hopefully you've gotten one. We're going to do the drawing towards the end of the program tonight. $5,000 for the grand prize winner. So somebody's going to be very, very happy. The auction seems to be doing well. I made note that Sister Margaret's dinner wasn't where I felt it should be. It has been clearly almost doubled since then. I still feel like you're going to hear from her if it doesn't get well above Cardinal Dolan's opportunity. So just keep bidding on that. Send your friends the links, get them involved. Cash donations of any amount really, really do go towards amazing works. The payback on this is a hundredfold down the road. So we encourage you to get involved wherever it is that you possibly can. Throughout our program tonight, you're going to hear from some wonderful and inspiring alumna. Some you already have. We have more on deck. Here is our first group of alumna we want you to hear from tonight.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dorothy Filaramo. As a student, alumna, and a member of the Board of Trustees twice, I have been inspired by the mission of Dominican Academy and its commitment to excellence. I have been blessed and cherish the friendships that have enriched my life. Just a bit of history. During my first board tenure in the early 90s, DA celebrated its 100th anniversary. In its honor, the board founded the Trustee Scholarship Fund, which has grown tenfold and which we celebrate every year with this gala and a benefit. How honored I am to be part of this tradition. Thank you for celebrating with us. Please enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. My name is Katie Hennessy, and I'm a proud member of the class of 2008. I'm thrilled to be here tonight to support DA for their first ever virtual auction and benefit. Congratulations to the honorees, Kristen Shea, and the Dovich family. As the school adapts to this new world of hybrid and remote learning, they need support of loyal and dedicated alumni like us, now more than ever. I've been actively bidding in the online auction. There are definitely some great prizes, and I will enthusiastically support the text to pledge tonight, as it will help raise funds that are necessary in order for the school to continue to thrive. Thank you, DA, for all you've done to help us smart girls become the intelligent women we are today. We're here now to ensure the school's success long into the future. Are you ready? Because I am. Let's get bidding!
Hi, DA family. Greetings from beautiful Naples, here at Castel del Lobo. My name is Camila Davila from the class of 2013. One of the things I treasure the most from my time at DA have been the incredible lifelong friendships I've made, friendships that have withstood the test of time and of distance. I'm also particularly grateful for the social, cultural, ethical, and spiritual teachings instilled in us by our teachers, not only during our daily lessons, but also during cultural activities like our museum trips, but also urban plunges and our yearly retreats. Sending a big hug to you all and a lot of solidarity during this difficult time. Ciao.
You're going to hear from more alumni as we go through this evening, but boy, how about that? Katie Hennessy, I need her. She's kind of like the auction hype gal. We need to have her follow me around. It's fantastic. Many of you are bidding. We're already seeing that. If you're not already on the website, get over there and take a look at it. Trips around, there's a trip to Africa for a safari. It's good for the next, I think, 2 or 3 years you have to redeem it in case travel's just not in your immediate future. We have sports tickets for both the Jets and the Giants. So, you know, good time to buy low right now. You can get in there. It is becoming a little bit more competitive. So we're hoping that they finish strong in the season. Other sports memorabilia, Knicks tickets. There's all kinds of stuff in there. If there's not something in this live auction for you, please let us know so that we can correct that for next year. But I feel like there's a wide arrangement of items in there that should make you happy. And again, if there isn't, then you certainly have the ability to simply make a contribution in cash and know that that goes directly towards helping these amazing young women. So, and when I say cash, obviously Visa, MasterCard, American Express, shiny stones, whatever you've got, we're happy to take it. A couple of other sponsors we want to mention, Anne-Marie Flynn Esquire, as well as Mr. and Mrs. Perlis, Frank and Antoinette Quitella, Brother James Simon in honor of the Dovich family, Robert and Kira Adamo, the Brady family, Mary Jane Burns Brady, John, and Jennifer Cagney, Charles and Kathleen Maher Foley, Mary Harrigan and Anthony Tothy, and Mary Jane Maher Higgins, and many, many more. We'll try and get in here. Please, if anything has been mispronounced, that's on me, nobody at the school, and you have my sincere apologies. Get your bidding going. Keep on contributing. We're already above, just short of $30,000. By the time I talk to you again, I'd like to see us above that. So get those bids in and keep contributing. In the meantime, here's a few more amazing alumna from DA.
Hi, my name is Nicole DeFilippi. I'm the co-president of the Alumni Association, a legacy DA girl, and a graduate of the class of 2010. I donate to DA in order to give back to the wonderful institution that has given me such an excellent education, lifelong friendships, and a fulfilling sense of community that I hope that by giving back, I am able to help ensure that future generations of DA girls get the opportunity to enrich their lives in the same way that I had.
Hi. This is Peggy Hanley, graduate of Dominican Academy, class of 1968. Dominican has always held a special place in my heart. It taught me confidence in myself and the importance of being smart and not hiding that. Through my undergraduate degree and various graduate programs, both in clinical social work and then in an MBA program, I relied on some of that confidence at times. And certainly the sense of digging deeper and understanding things and high expectations. That's meant a lot to me. It's helped me very much in my career. And I support that with my 7 grandchildren now. Were I living on the East Coast, I'd encourage my 2 granddaughters to go to Dominican. But while that won't happen, I hope and continue to support Dominican Academy so that others may have that benefit. Thanks so much and good health to all of you. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. I'm Kayla, member of the graduating class of 2019 and present sophomore at Loyola University, Maryland. One reason why I love DA is that it set the standards really high. It set the standards high for myself because I knew that nothing but the best was expected of me, that I should try everything and make the most of every opportunity. It set really high expectations for my teachers because at DA I had the most incredible teachers who would sit with me in the morning and in the afternoon and in between classes to make sure that I was really getting the most out of my education. And lastly, it set the standard really high for incredible friends, friends who taught me what it meant to be loving and kind and patient. And those are lessons that I take with me every day, and I am so thankful that I am a DA girl.
Oh, what a wonderful little break there. Thank you to Kayla, as well as Nicole and Peggy, all the way in from San Diego. So we thank you so much for tuning in as well and your continued support. It truly is a testament to the friendships and the bonds that are developed at Dominican, because these people that have been out of the school now for, well, many years, let's leave it at that, continue to support even when, you know, as Peggy said, she doesn't have any kids at the school anymore. and continues to give as an alumnus. So it really is a great strength of the school, and I couldn't be more pleased to be here tonight. Check your bids. We're doing fantastic. Again, you've got until Tuesday on everything in the auction. Your contributions tonight are fund a need, if you will, going towards the scholarship and the continuing needs of the young women in the school. Those are being collected tonight as well. So please get those in whenever you can. Take a look at the thermometer. We're at 28,425. Not bad, but we can do better. I want to see us hit that goal of 50,000. Thanks to Madeline for making her contribution tonight, and the Metzler family, and everybody that has given us something. Every dollar counts. Again, text your friends and tell them, challenge them to $10 to make a contribution. It all adds up as we go through this tonight. Great items still available. How about a chance to play at Westchester Country Club? You're probably not a member there. You may not ever get asked to be a member there. This is your best opportunity. Go with a member, you and two of your friends, the three of you, your greens fees, your caddies, your tips, your lunch, everything is taken care of. Our premier items, the Italian Learn How to Cook and Dinner with a Dr. Petit is available and continues to climb up. There's a little bit of a competition going on between Dr. Petit and Sister Margaret. So we're kind of watching to see how that all plays out, but be sure to get in there and bid on it. These are once in a lifetime opportunities. And as much as I wish I was there pointing at hands and doing this in a live auction, we just won't be able to do that tonight, so I've got to rely on you to be competitive there. So we're pushing towards that $30,000 mark. It's absolutely fantastic. We thank you again. Text Dominican Academy to 243-725. Send that to your friends and let them get involved as well. A few other sponsors we want to mention tonight: Mary Beth Wagner Daughtry, the Epiphany School, Mary Kate Curran and Andrew Schwarzen, Glenn and Catherine Gregorio, Michael Horahan and Jasmine Dong Horahan, Terrence and Andrea Canningizer, Maureen A. Lynch, and Maury and Maria Michelle, John P. O'Toole, Craig and Kathleen Seidel, and Paul and Bita Tanuzo, and many, many more. Again, all listed on the website. We thank each and every one of you. We've got another group of amazing alumni we want you to hear from: Roseanne, Beyonce, and Jen. Let's hear from them now.
My name is Roseanne Morrison, and I am a graduate of Dominican Academy. Dominican Academy has served to be a very strong foundation in my life. It has served me deeply spiritually. It has helped me navigate a lot of the challenges of my life and also provided me with lifelong friendships.
Hello, good night. My name is Beyonce King, and I graduated from DA in 2019, and I am now a sophomore at Marquette University in nursing school. And something about DA that's very special to me and that, like, I will never forget are the teachers. It was their dedication and their willingness to stay back and to quiz me, to go over test questions, to answer all my questions. That made all the difference in my experience. And I'll never forget those late afternoons.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Reardon. I'm a graduate of the class of 1998 and current History Department Chairperson and Moderator of Student Council. When I think about what I love most about DA, the word that comes to mind is space. And while I do love our beautiful building, the space I'm talking about is the space to become. DA gives its students the space to become creators, clearer thinkers, and leaders. I get to see this every day in my classroom and in student council. One of the best parts of my job is being able to listen to our students' ideas, talk them through it, and give them the space, the tools, and the support they need to enact them. And every time, I'm floored by the results.
Again, amazing alumna. We wish we could feature each and every one of them tonight, but it just, again, just goes to show the wide range of young women and how they've all turned out, and the ones that come back to continue teaching. I mean, that is just truly something very, very special. Again, a reminder, if you have not bid or you've not found something, get on that website and look around. Bidpal.net /Dominican Academy. You can reach it probably directly through the DA website and find some items in there that you can't live without. We could use your support tonight. We continue to do pretty well. We're seeing those numbers go up there. Our goal is 50,000 for the night tonight. We're getting close to 30,000. We know we got some people that have mailed in checks and maybe we haven't gotten those yet, but they'll certainly go in there. We'll keep you updated. Again, that the auction continues through Tuesday. Thanks to Justin Sousa for making a contribution as well. We thank you, Justin, and everybody else. Again, if you're sending that text message to your friends, I can't imagine they don't have $10 to help out a great school. So be sure to send that over to them as well. We have our raffle. And for those of you that haven't signed up, all I can do is tell you just lavish and enjoy the fact that somebody else has won a bunch of money. So we have a total of three prizes to give out tonight. The first prize is going to be $5,000. The second prize is $2,500. Third place is $1,000. So pretty good run there for our winners. And I have them here. We put together, we have all of them. They were sent over and we cut them all up in here. And you're all going to win. Well, three of you are going to win. Hopefully you're watching. How exciting would that be? So this is going to be your first place winner, and we'll read them in reverse order because that's just more fun that way. So that's your first place has been drawn officially. That's your winner right there. Okay. Oh, did I show it to you? Okay. I'm going to show you this only because this could only happen on a live broadcast. I personally cut all these names up. This is the one that I just pulled. I want to show you. Somehow or another, I got a blank one in there. So that will not be our $5,000 winner. We'll draw again. I don't think there can't be more than one of those in here. So here we go. All right, I have our first. This is your first one, first place. That'll be for $5,000. Second place, right here. This will be your second place winner. And your third place winner is right here. So here's this, your third place winner. And $1,000 to them is going to Mary and Andrew Harrington Tuffy. Mary and Andrew Harrington Tuffy, you guys are the $1,000 winners. The $2,500 winner is Joy Holes. Joy Holes, H-O-L-Z. Congratulations, you've won $2,500. And our grand prize winner, I just now thought of a drum roll. That would have been a good idea here. But we'll go without it. This is your grand prize winner. This is $5,000 in this year's raffle. Goes to, I kid you not, there aren't four people that I know personally from Dominican Academy. This is the first time that I've worked with this amazing organization. So I haven't had a chance to meet everybody, but I kid you not, I have just pulled one of the first names that I ever knew. Congratulations to James Simon, who is your winner over there. So I'll let him deal with the politics of the development office winning $5,000, but I'm sure he'll find good use for it. So congratulations to Mary and Andrew, as well as Joy and James for being our grand prize winner there tonight. So you couldn't make it up, folks. That is pretty much it for me tonight. Again, I can't tell you, there's nothing more as an auctioneer I like doing more than getting in front of a crowd and making a lot of noise and raising some money and feeling the excitement of the crowd. And we certainly miss that element by doing this virtually. But I feel your love and I feel your appreciation for the school and for these young women. And I thank you for being here tonight and making this all possible. Please continue to bid. Again, we're open until Tuesday on that. You're going to get lots of reminders. You've still got opportunities to make contributions, whether they be cash or they be items that you're purchasing. But again, all of that money going towards maintaining this amazing tradition at DA. And I thank you all so very much. Please be safe. Don't forget to vote on November 3rd. And we finish up tonight with Sister Margaret for some final thoughts and a wonderful closing video. Please take care of yourselves. God bless.
Before you leave this evening, I want to tell you that I can't thank you enough for your generosity this evening. Your donations during this program and the bids on the auction items that will remain open until Tuesday evening at 9 p.m. will do so much to support our school. They will provide scholarships to those most in need, including and especially those whose situations have been impacted by COVID-19. They allow us to keep the tuition as low as possible for all of our students, and they help us to ensure that we have the most up-to-date technology to provide best distance learning experience available. I would like to thank our principal, Dr. Leslie Petit, our faculty and staff for their tireless efforts in service to our students. Thank you to our Board of Trustees for giving so generously of themselves and providing us throughout with clear leadership. And I would like to thank our Gala Committee, those who solicited gifts and reached out to encourage participation, and those who donated items. I would also like to extend my deepest appreciation to our honorees, Kristen Che and the Dovich family, for their ongoing support of our beloved school. Please continue to pray for us, and I promise to hold you in my prayers until we can be together again in person to celebrate our beautiful Dominican Academy community. Thank you, safe home, and good night.
To the demons they